Hey everybody, I'd like to talk today about when you do some soundproofing and you do the right thing. However, it doesn't resolve all of your noise issues. And that's because a lot of times noise has to be treated in different ways. And you might do one solution and it turns out there's actually a second problem that you need to address. And in particular, we're going to talk today about creating a decoupled ceiling and how it might solve 80% of your issue, but not all of it. That doesn't mean that you made a mistake when you decoupled the ceiling. It probably means that you had more than one type of noise and more than one noise path. So I've talked before about how the best way to stop noise is at the source, but you also need to take a look at the path of the noise. So let's look at an example with an upstairs and a downstairs apartment. Let's say the downstairs neighbor hears conversation noise and TV, and they're really bothered by impact noise from footfalls, maybe even some vibration noise. So let's take a look at the path. The sound waves from the airborne noise are bouncing around, and a lot of that sound goes through the hollow floor and into the downstairs apartment. Maybe the airborne noise even goes through some pipes and ventilation ducts in the walls. And the impact noise from upstairs is going right into the floor joists and through the ceiling below, which of course is attached to the joists. But some of it might also transfer to the wall studs and down to the apartment below. Now let's take a look at the noise from downstairs to upstairs. The conversation noise comes up through the downstairs ceiling and maybe even the walls into the upstairs apartment. And when people walk in the downstairs apartment, their impact noise goes into their floor joists, up the wall studs, and into the floor joists of the upstairs apartment. So what happens when you build a decoupled ceiling in the downstairs apartment? First, let's take a look at the process. You remove the existing drywall from the joists. And inside the cavity, some people might attach pieces of gypsum board or another dampening material to the bottom of the upstairs subfloor with green glue or with caulk. They insert it between each joist to add some mass and dampening to the bottom of the subfloor. Then some people might also wrap mass-loaded vinyl around the floor joists. That also helps to block some airborne noise from going upstairs. Then add insulation over the mass-loaded vinyl and then attach furring channels to the joists. That's where you hang the drywall from. Then attach the drywall, and that should be a sound-dampened drywall like Quiet Rock 530. Then use acoustical caulk around the edges. So the results. The downstairs apartment doesn't get airborne noise from the upstairs anymore. The impact noise is also significantly reduced because there's no longer a direct connection between the upstairs floor and the downstairs ceiling. But remember what I told you before about flanking noise. If there's a heavy enough impact, it could potentially still come through the framing into the downstairs walls. So what about the upstairs apartment? Again, the airborne noise that comes from downstairs is pretty much gone, but the impact noise is not. So why is that? Because think about it. The impact noise bypasses the new decoupled ceiling. The noise path is going from the floor to the wall studs and then into the floor joists upstairs. It is not going through the ceiling. It never did. So it doesn't matter if the ceiling is decoupled. It won't prevent the downstairs impact noise from traveling upstairs. That's just something to keep in mind. Don't think our new ceiling didn't work. Yes, it did. It just means that the downstairs apartment still needs to deal with dampening the impact noise from the floor. At the very least, it just means that they still need to have a rug and a carpet pad down there. So in summary, every sound has a path or multiple paths. You need to consider the root of those paths when you try to solve a noise problem. One solution might not eliminate all types of noise. The solution might be iterative. Thanks for watching, and for more information about noise and acoustics, visit soundproofist.com.